Hello, I'm Darrell Bailey, a professor of music in the Department of Music and Arts Technology in Purdue School of Engineering and Technology. I've used course networking for the past 7 years, and most recently ePortfolio for this past year. It's truly been a transforming environment for my students. The way that I use it in the course is as a graded assignment. Students are asked to create a showcase in which they look at their academic major and relate that to music. This is fascinating for them, many times because they can take a discipline such as nursing, motorsports engineering, technology, the sciences, and relate that back to music and the history of music, and also ways that they might be able to use music in their academic discipline. I would also like to say that it's gratifying to have an environment that I can leave with the students, particularly freshmen, that they can continue to use lifelong. It's a true legacy of impact that the ePortfolio and course networking is making not only to my students, but also to students globally.
CN ePortfolio is the foundation of our Gateway to Capstone ePortfolio initiative in communication studies at IUPUI. We use ePortfolios to track student learning related to the student learning outcomes that we have defined for our major. The learning outcomes are the things that we want our students to know and be able to do by the time they finish their degree with us. In order to assess whether they're actually attaining those learning outcomes, we've integrated ePortfolio throughout the curriculum, starting with the Gateway course. In the Gateway, students are introduced to CN, and they're asked to create folders using the documents function or feature in ePortfolio, in CN ePortfolio. There's one folder for each of the 10 learning outcomes. Then throughout their course of study, they're asked to populate those folders with evidence of and reflections about their learning related to each of the learning outcomes. And then finally in the capstone, we switch our attention to showcase. Using the showcase function of CN ePortfolio, we help students figure out ways to take that archived evidence of their learning and highlight their special competencies and skills as communication professionals in the showcases. I think our use of CN ePortfolio benefits students in several ways. One of the first is that it provides them with a powerful tool for telling their story as emerging communication professionals. Related to that, I think it's useful as sort of a virtual resume. Increasingly, employers are asking applicants to prove the claims that they're making on their standard resumes, and the ePortfolio provides a very good place to do that because it provides actual evidence of what they've done. And finally, in the reflections that I've received from students who have participated in the initiative, several of them have mentioned that they themselves really appreciate having to go back and reflect on their learning, to synthesize the learning across courses, to integrate what they've done co-curricular activities into their classroom learning. And all in all, I think it's a win-win for both the department and the students.
We have been using the CN's ePortfolio in our National Science Foundation sponsored project called the STEM Collaboratory, in collaboration with the University of Memphis and the University of Colorado at Denver. Our students start in a cohort during the summer bridge orientation using ePortfolio. This gives them an opportunity to establish their STEM identity from the very first time they step on campus. What we have found is the ePortfolio is a great way for students to continue to expand upon their STEM identity all throughout their undergraduate curriculum. For example, the ePortfolio includes ways for the students to get badges. We award badges for things like performing an internship. And this internship could be many different dimensions. It could be a research internship, working in the community on a diversity initiative, a variety of activities under an internship. So badging is a way for the student to have additional credentials to share with not only their colleagues, but eventually employers. ePortfolio is a way to establish and then sustain a STEM identity, and we hope that STEM identity gets stronger and stronger as the student approaches their graduation.
Hello, my name is Elaine Cooney, and I'm a faculty member here at IUPUI in the School of Engineering Technology. My program is Electrical Engineering Technology in the Department of Engineering Technology. And the course that we use ePortfolio in is a course for single articulation pathway transfer students from Ivy Tech. So it's very important that the students be ready to start their junior year with the same abilities and skills and success as students that are native to our program. And we use ePortfolio as a way to have the students collect and reflect on the work they've done and specifically target things that we know are going to be very useful during their first semester and first year as juniors in our program. We use it in, first of all, so they can curate the materials that they think best demonstrate how they've met the core competencies that have been agreed upon by all the faculty across the state. And then we also have them reflect on how they've met the core competencies. Some of my colleagues have asked me why we should use course networking rather than LinkedIn. And I understand the fact that LinkedIn is a very good way for students to market themselves to potential employers. But the benefit of course networking is that I can badge the students' work. I can verify that they completed the work for my class. And then also, if the students want to use it for potential employers, they can always put a URL link to their ePortfolio and then use that to market themselves on LinkedIn or other platforms as they see fit. So I see the course networking ePortfolio as something that's very portable. Students can use it when they're at Ivy Tech, they can continue to use it while they're here at IUPUI, and then use it to market themselves to potential employers.
I used the CNE portfolio in the Kelley School Study Abroad China program in spring 2017 and spring 2019. My students use CNE portfolio to document their learning throughout the course. They included diverse artifacts in multimedia formats to communicate and showcase their skills, experiences, and learning. I believe it's much more than writing reflection papers. My students' ePortfolios on the CN listed their individual personal learning goals. They elaborated lessons, insights, or important takeaways from both classroom learning and the trip. I believe CN helped my students to integrate learning process and their accomplishments toward their personal learning goals. They showed their understanding about global business and cross-cultural communication, which is crucial for their academic studies and the future business career.
Hi, I'm Michelle Quirke. I'm an instructor for Summer Bridge courses and the first year seminar. And one of the things we use the ePortfolio is to help students document that journey from the time they arrive on campus to when they finish my course and then continue on their academic journey. So one of the things I really like about using the ePortfolio is this is an opportunity for students to explore careers and majors and find things that they like and really spotlight that in their ePortfolio with the skills section. When they make connections with other instructors through the badging, they can incorporate all of those courses together, not just my course, and so they can carry that with them. Main reason I use course networking is because it's open. There's a global market where the students can post things and others can comment on it. That really excites them when they're researching, say, a nursing or social work to see how these types of systems function in other countries. Or it can be something where they can show their mom, you know, they can email a link to their mom and talk to them. Or they can share other instructors and say, am I capturing, you know, what this course is, what I'm supposed to be doing with it. So I've used it for about several years and I've found the students really work well with the non-scripted creativity behind it. They're allowed to explore and document things. The one thing that I have found is I use a rubric and I created that with the course networking staff. And I found that was really nice to show them when they set those goals and career objectives, if they're developing those, and if they have emerging skills, and then when they become proficient and at a freshman level or a sophomore level. And then once they leave my course, they can continue to build those.